So I've got a Brita filter here, and I'm going to do three different experiments. First, I'm going to use tap water, then water mixed with soil, and lastly, I'm going to use water that contains microbes and bacteria. We're going to test it using this microscope.
In order to get as close as possible to accurate results, I cleaned the slides with special lens paper and isopropanol. First, I'll check distilled water as a reference to examine any potential impurities that may come from the glass itself. When you look at water under a microscope, it's hard to tell if the things you see come from the slide or from the water. As expected, it's very clean. There are some small dust particles that I'm sure didn't originate from the water. Let's keep this in mind as a reference for our first experiment with the tap water. It's important to note that in Germany, tap water goes through a filtration process and is considered safe for drinking. However, there are many factors that can impact its quality. At 100 times magnification, we can immediately observe the presence of tiny particles moving in the water. Although some of them may originate from the glass, using the dark-field filter allows us to observe their movement. Let's find out how many contaminants the Brita filter will remove. To ensure the experiment is accurate, I'll use a new cartridge and strictly follow the instructions provided on the package. I didn't include all the footage in the video, but rest assured, I went through all the steps and I'm now ready to fill it up with the tap water we previously observed. Let's take a sample and compare. The difference might not be significant, but it's still noticeable. Keep in mind, as Brita advertises its product, the primary purpose is to reduce the taste and smell of chlorine from the tap water, while also removing certain components like zinc and copper. From what I can see, it will certainly allow some dirt to pass through, and that's perfectly fine, because it's not designed for filtering out dirt water. However, here we're going to dive into this experiment with some dirty water just for the sheer joy of watching and comparing the filtration results. Let's give it a good mix and take our sample. Don't be fooled by its clean appearance. It's packed with dirt and possibly some tiny life forms. It might appear as if they're alive, but it's simply Brownian motion, resulting from the collision of dirt particles with rapidly moving atoms and molecules in the water. Except for this little fellow. He's definitely alive and appears somewhat puzzled. To observe the tiniest bits and particles, I'll go back to using dark field once again. I don't think the Brita filter stands a chance here. Nevertheless, let's put it to the test. Replacing the filter on time is crucial, because if it's neglected for too long, there's a high chance it will start contaminating your water, which is something nobody wants. Unless you're into it, let me know in the comments. The filter is performing better than I expected. The water, while slightly yellowish, seems to be quite clean overall. This looks almost drinkable. Well done, Brita. I suspect this improvement is because larger chunks of dirt are getting trapped in the filter, while some of the smaller ones are clumping together into larger particles, which will likely meet the same fate during the filtration. I'm quite certain that bacteria can easily pass through, but what about microbes? Our final experiment involves using seawater, which I collected from the Baltic Sea. I expect it to be thriving with microorganisms. I strongly recommend against putting your filter through similar tests, unless you're prepared to replace it. While these microbes are harmless, there may be unknown bacteria growing inside, and it's risky to continue using the filter after exposing it to such experiments. Considering that these microbes are moving within a biofilm they essentially created over time, there is a possibility that the entire slimy substance of the biofilm could become trapped in the filter. Let's find out if that is the case. As anticipated, the water has become clean, and there is no biofilm remaining. However, smaller microorganisms did manage to pass through the filter, indicating that bacteria, which can be even smaller, will likely make their way into the water after filtration. But who in the right mind would intentionally put bacteria into the water filter anyway? Do you have Brita at home? Let me know in the comments when was the last time you replaced its cartridge. It was my first lengthy video on YouTube, so if you subscribe, it would make me happy. Thanks for watching.